Garrett Blevins here with Josh Matos behind the camera to talk to you about daily undulating periodization. I want to talk to you about this because this has taken my 1559 raw total at 220 to 1719 in only 1 year. And I had a gym total of 1845. I'm telling you, this stuff works. And I'm going to tell you why it works. First off, we need to understand strength. And strength is a measure of how much you can lift. You guys know that. As you train, your strength is going to go up because neurological adaptation goes up. You're training your muscles how to lift. However, as you adapt neurologically, it starts to flatline. Your muscles adapt really fast. That's how our bodies work. They get used to the stimulus we put ourselves under. And so as you're training, you're going to get those beginner gains that are going to be awesome, and then you're going to hit plateaus. And you're just going to keep going to the gym, and you're going to lift the same weight, and you're going to wonder why. Here's why. Because you fully adapted with the amount of muscle that you have, you're not going to be able to lift anymore. The solution to this is hypertrophy. As you are gaining strength because of neurological adaptation, you need to be building bigger muscles. Because when neurological adaptation flatlines, your strength will flatline as well, unless you have the hypertrophy coming up to keep your base of strength high. If you don't have the hypertrophy, you're going to hit those plateaus and you're going to stop. At some point, a small body can only lift so much weight. So you got to get big. Let me tell you how. Daily undulating periodization. Daily undulating periodization is the key. Linear periodization works. Daily undulating periodization is better. Here's why. You get the sarcoplasmic protein synthesis from the 8 to 12 rep range. Yeah, I said that right. I don't know what it means, but I know what it looks like. It looks like you're getting bigger and stronger. Now, you're going to get myofibular hypertrophy from the lower rep ranges, which is important, but you need to have both. And daily undulating periodization gives you both, whereas linear periodization really focuses on the myofibular hypertrophy. Here's what I mean. Let's take the red line as volume and the blue line as intensity. Your volume is going to be low when you're doing these 1 to 3 rep ranges in daily undulating periodization. Duh. However, your intensity is going to be high, so you're working that maximal strength. You're working sport-specific exercises. So you're working the squat, bench, and deadlift, and you're working them with heavy weights to get used to your competitions where you do the squat, bench, and deadlift with heavy weights. It makes you better at them. It makes sense. It's obvious. But you also need to be on them gains with those muscles, and so you've got to be doing hypertrophy. That's why day one, let's say that's your squat day. Day two is your bench day. Day three is your deadlift day. Day one with squats, you're working heavy. You're getting strong. Day two with bench, you're doing the bread and butter, which is both strength and hypertrophy. This is where you're building your base. You're getting a little bit of that sarcoplasmic stuff, but it's not the full thing. So you're doing kind of half and half, which is good to do. That's where you're building a base of strength, as well as building your muscles. And on day three, you come into deadlift, but you're doing 8 to 12 reps with low intensity, maybe 65%. And that's going to build your muscles so that you can get stronger. And here's how you get stronger. That's week one. On week two, you change it up. It's daily undulating periodization. It's undulating. It's going up and down. And so when you come in for squats, now you're doing squats, bread and butter, 5x5 maybe. And you're doing your really intense bench workout. Get them big pecs going on. Get them tries going on. That's what you're doing on day two. And then you come in for day three on deadlift, and you're working with higher intensities and lower volume. And so you're taking that muscle that you were building the previous week, and you're training it to be the strongest muscle it can be, the best it can be. Now, in contrast, linear periodization, such as what Omar put out, which works because it functions with that neurological adaptation. That's how you do that. Linear periodization, if you start with a 5x5, is completely missing the sarcoplasmic protein synthesis. You're not getting the hypertrophy that you would get from daily undulating periodization because your sole focus is on strength. And as you go through the weeks, you lower the reps, you increase the intensity. But again, where's the 8x12? Now you can have that in your isolation movements. You can throw that in after your main work. But that's not going to give you the same effects that daily undulating periodization does. And certainly, if you go into the gym and all you're doing is the main lifts, and you're only doing them with linear periodization, with no assistance work, no lat pull-downs, no tricep extensions, no bicep curls, no pec flies, whatever, then you're not getting your optimal gains because you're not building the body that can handle those big weights. And you got to ask yourself out there, do you want to be a buck 30 and maybe bench 300? Or do you want to be 240 and bench 500? For me, I want to be as big and as bad and as strong as I possibly can. And so I'm going to focus on hypertrophy and strength. And if you want to have your weight class records, that's fine. I respect that. That's great. But I'm trying to be the biggest and the baddest. If you are too, then think about daily undulating periodization. Wherever you guys, girls are at out there, blessings.